Hi, Scott. My name is Mohammed, and I listen to your podcast on a regular basis. So I wanted to say thank you. I find them to be very helpful. My question today is regarding podcast 119. And my question is specifically regarding, let's say if I have one product, garlic press, and I have that keyword garlic press as an exact match campaign. And also I have garlic press as a keyword in phrase match campaign. Do these two campaigns compete against each other? Well, that's my first question. The second question is, let's say if I have two products, complementary products, and they have overlapping keywords, do my pay-per-click campaigns for these two products compete against each other since they have overlapping keywords? Appreciate if you can answer the question. Thank you very much.
Hey, Mohammed, thank you so much for the question. And it's a great question. And yes, episode 119 with Chris Schaefer, we talked all about pay-per-click, and he did cover some of this in there. Now, if you have not listened to that episode yet, I would definitely strongly recommend going and checking that out. That's theamazingseller.com/119. And you can hear all about that there. Now, let me just kind of say this, all right? Now, you are kind of competing against yourself in a sense if you have a exact keyword that you're targeting and then one that might be in a phrase or even in a broad kinda. See, the thing is with broad, it's going to pick up, like if you do garlic press, it's going to find anything with garlic and anything with press, okay? So you are going to have like more range on that. So in that particular case, I would be more or less thinking of if you have a campaign that has a phrase match. Now, a phrase match would be something like garlic press, all right? And then it would have to have that in it, okay? That would be the phrase that needs to be in it, but it could have black handled garlic press or garlic press stainless steel. So that way there, you could have garlic press in there somewhere, but it would not necessarily just be the exact match. Now, if you do an exact match, it's exactly what that is. It's an exact match. So one way that you could kind of prevent this from happening is inside of your phrase match campaign, you could add a negative keyword. That negative keyword could be garlic press, right? So if you don't want to compete with yourself against, you know, each campaign that you have, then you would want to put a negative keyword in there. So this way here, that would take care of that. Now in a broad match, I don't necessarily think that that's, I'm not even sure if that's possible, but I don't necessarily think that you would have to do that because in a broad, it's going to be taking a broad match of everything. Okay. So it's really only going to make sense if you did an exact keyword. Let's say you did an exact campaign for garlic press, and then you had a phrase match for garlic press. Then from there, you would just say inside of the phrase match campaign, negative keyword, garlic press. And that would be the simplest thing. Now, you also mentioned you have other variations for this particular keyword. Now, if that's the case, you have a choice. You can either, yes, run that keyword against both of them. And even if you just kept the bids at the same, you're only going to be a few pennies maybe differently than if you're going to be competing against yourself. So I don't necessarily think that I would worry about that, especially if you want to drive people to different product listings or different variations. And I guess if you have two different listings, then that definitely you would want to still rank for both of them. Because if you could take up two spots, well, why wouldn't you want to, right? But I think you're going to find, especially if you have a variation, you're going to find out what variation is the one that you want to drive traffic to and then use that one as your lead in, let's call it. And then from there, that would bring them to your other variations. So I hope that that's helped you. I hope that makes sense. And again, you have to experiment with this type of stuff. There's no really exact like formula for that. But what I would say is if you're going after like just one keyword, I get it, but you really need to understand that particular keyword. We were just on a coaching call for my class the other day. And, one of our students was saying, that she was running a campaign that was an exact match for this one keyword. And, it wasn't performing that great because she wasn't getting that as many impressions as she she wanted, or she was spending too much. She was getting impressions, but she was spending too much and all of this. But then she was also running a phrase match. And I immediately told her, listen, unless that exact keyword is already converting really well for you, I would just keep it in a phrase match. And then I would just let the exact match go until I knew that that one there was like a really strong keyword that was going to convert really, really well. So just a little side tip there for you, or a little side note. So just make sure that if once you start running an exact match keyword, you want to make sure that that keyword is converting really, really well. Not just converting a couple times. We're talking like converting over and over and over again. So this way here, you can start to scale that keyword and start throwing more money at it. All right. So hopefully that's helped you. Good luck to you. Keep me posted. If you guys want to submit a question, head over to theamazingseller.com/ask and you can do that. I want to also, again, remind you guys, if you're brand new and this is your first time to the show, I want to welcome you. I love hanging out with you guys. This is just awesome to be able to virtually connect like this. And that's why I love the Ask Scott sessions. But if you are brand new and you're just getting your feet wet and you don't understand the entire process, the entire business model, I would recommend attending one of my live free workshops. This is where I break it down for you in five phases: how to pick a market and a product, how to source it, how to do a pre-launch, how to do a launch, how to promote the product, and everything in between. We go over that on a workshop, and we go through every single thing. We also do live Q&A. So if you want to attend one of them, I would love to invite you to the next one, and you can register for the next one by heading over to theamazingseller.com/workshop, and you can register there for an upcoming workshop. Well, hey there. Thank you so much for listening to that episode of Ask Scott. Now, that was just a highlight from one of our full episodes where I generally answer 3 to 4 questions on a podcast. If you want to go back and listen to all of the past archives of not just the Ask Scott session, but all of the full episodes where I do interviews with top Amazon sellers, people starting from scratch and building a business, if you want to listen to any of those episodes, head over to theamazingseller.com and you can find all of that over there. You can also find details there on how you can ask your own question and get it aired on an upcoming Ask Scott session and possibly see it here on YouTube or just on the podcast. All right, so definitely head over to theamazingseller.com. There's tons of resources over there for you to be able to build your e-commerce and Amazon business. So definitely go check that out. Now, I just wanted to remind you one thing before I let you go. There's a lot of information out there and some of it is really, really good. What I want you to remember is you have to not just consume the information, you have to actually apply that information. So take this information that you learned here today and apply it to your business. And this way here, you can get results. As my shirt says, I wear it almost daily. Take action. We'll see you guys.